to know. What are waves? One of the things many people love about the ocean is the waves. People love to play in the waves. Love to surf the waves. And love the sound of the waves crashing on the beach. But have you ever wondered how these waves are formed? Ocean waves are caused by wind moving across the surface of the water. The friction between the air molecules and the water molecules causes energy to be transferred from the wind to the water. This causes waves to form. In science, a wave is defined as a transfer of energy. Ocean waves are called mechanical waves because they travel through a medium. The medium in this case is water. The water doesn't actually travel with the wave, but only moves up and down. It's the energy that travels with the wave. The highest point of the wave is called the wave crest. And the lowest point of the wave is called the wave trough. Waves vary in size. The force and speed of the wind blowing over the surface of the water causes different size of waves. These waves move together in groups across the fluid surface at the same speed and in regular intervals. This movement of waves as a group is known as a wave train. Waves in the oceans can travel hundreds of miles before reaching land. The tallest wave ever measured was 1,719 feet at Lituya Bay, Alaska. The tallest wave recorded in the open ocean was 95 feet during a storm near Scotland. There are different types of ocean waves. The wind-driven waves begin as ripples, which are small and have the shortest period of time between successive wave crests. They increase in size if wind gets stronger. If heavy winds from tropical storms or other wind systems drive the waves, they can create ocean swells that are capable of traveling long distances over entire ocean systems. Swells are rolling waves that travel long distances through the ocean. They are not generated by the local wind, but by distant storms. Swells are typically smooth waves, not choppy like wind waves. A tsunami is a type of wave that is not started by the wind. It is defined as a series of waves, caused by an earthquake, underwater volcanic eruption, landslide, or other abrupt disturbances. Tsunamis can result in massive destruction when they arrive on shore. This fact became evident in March of 2011, when Japan was struck by a large tsunami that was triggered by a 9.0 magnitude earthquake. The tsunami claimed the lives of more than 15,000 people. Damaged several nuclear power plant reactors. And caused billions of dollars in damage. A tidal wave is another type of wave, and it's sometimes confused with a tsunami. While both types of waves are large, a tidal wave is a large wave caused by the tides. Tides are predictable events that are created by the gravitational pull of the sun and the moon on the Earth. More potentially hazardous waves can be caused by severe weather, like a hurricane. The strong winds and pressure from this type of severe storm causes storm surge, a series of long waves that are created far from shore in deeper water and intensify as they move closer to land. There are three basic types of breaking waves: spilling breaker waves, plunging breaker waves, and surging breaker waves. 1. Spilling breaker waves. Spilling breaker waves are produced when the ocean floor has a gentle slope. As the wave approaches the shore, it slowly releases energy, and the crest gradually spills forward down its face until it is all white water. These waves take more time to break than any other wave. Two, plunging breaker waves. Plunging breaker waves are produced when the ocean floor has steep bottoms. The crest of the wave becomes much steeper than a spilling wave. It becomes vertical, then curls over and drops onto the trough of the wave, releasing most of its energy at once in a relatively violent impact. Three, surging breaker waves. Surging breaker waves are produced when the ocean floor has very steep or vertical bottom. The wave doesn't spill or curl. It builds up and then slides rapidly up the beach with less foam or spray than the other two breakers. Some of the energy moves back to the sea, often appearing as backwash. a surging breaker wave will cause the most coastal erosion because it slams into the beach at full speed. Ocean waves are very important for weather forecasting and climate modeling. Ocean waves are thought to play a role in weather forecasting, such as improving hurricane intensity forecasts by regulating surface friction. Ocean waves are also important for coastal communities, shipping routes, and offshore industry. Moreover, waves help to minimize the extremes in the planet's temperature, moving cold water away from the poles, while at the same time moving warm waters from the equator towards them. Thanks for watching the video. For more update to my new videos, press the bell icon, and please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.